All right, so this here,
CJ Willey, or I like to call him CJ Dubs, right? He's actually the whole reason I made this channel, right? Which I didn't tell you that. Woo. But it was because it was the first time I was using SwingVision. I was using a GoPro, and our match was so long that the GoPro ran out of battery, which really sucked. So that's why I had to switch to Apple. You start using my phone. But it was like in the third set tiebreaker, it was at 9-all, right? We had like a 50-shot rally, like lobs, drop shots, everything, dude. Yeah. After that point, I was just like, oh my gosh, where's the camera? Like, no one's going to believe me about this point. And it was like, win or lose, like I went to the net, and I'm just like, this was a Warriors battle, right? Like, it was one of the most satisfying handshakes of my life. Like, it really was, dude. Like, it was just, I hope we have another battle like that. It was intense. Neither of us wanted to go down. Like, we both had that mentality. If we're going down, we're going out fighting, right? He was cramping. I was fighting for everything. I was like, oh my gosh. But that's what tennis is all about. And so that's like the whole reason, like, I wanted to kind of start this channel and interview people, right? Cool. So that's a little bit about CJ that, from my perspective, what I know. He's also a coach. We're up here in Boulder. Kind of cloudy day, but it's perfect. So I'll just ask you, what do you like about tennis? What keeps you in the sport? What's your favorite thing about it? What do you love?
Yeah. You know what? I remember that handshake and just the feeling of like, man, I'm really proud of you. That's like, I'm really proud of you.
Yeah,
you know, and that's a beautiful thing when you can recognize that in an opponent and you say, hey, you gave it all you got. You know, we had an awesome battle, and I'm proud of you. I will say why I play tennis, it's the people, right? It's the people that I meet. And as I get older, I have 4 kids. I'm busy. I'm a busy dad. Like, it checks all the boxes for me. It's the people I meet. It's my main social outlet, right? And I've really seen, I've had some great, you know, kind of coaches and mentors in this last, like, 5 years when I've gotten back into it. Damon Gillette down at Denver Tennis Club, and the way you can just positively impact someone's life just by, hey, they came out today, they had a lot of things they could have done, everybody's busy, they picked up a racket, they went out, they said, I'm gonna get better, and I'm gonna connect with other people, and that's why I love this sport, and it's my main thing, and this is my happy place up here in Boulder, Colorado, and I'm so grateful to be able to play with you today, Jarron.
We're kids. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Yeah.
How old are you?
I'm 43.
Oh my gosh, dude. This
43.
Guy's fast.
Playing 40 plus now. There's a guy up here in Boulder County named Bob Litwin that's won over 30 gold balls through the age divisions, right? So you win a USTA gold ball if you win nationals.
Yeah.
And he's motivating me to now play in some like age division tournaments. And so that's kind of the next evolution of where I'm going with this sport, but also just like I love playing with people like young kids on the way up, and you know, I get a lot out of this sport. I get more out of this sport than I put in, you know, but I just love it.
Dang, dude, awesome.
Yeah.
All right, well, we're also gonna do something I've wanted to do for a while here. I used to do it in college with my buddies, called Racket Swap. So we're actually gonna switch rackets right now, right? We're gonna talk a little bit about them. So this right here is the Speed Pro, Head Speed Pro. It's the generation from 2014. It's red, black, and white, but I did get it customized. My old job did that, all about tennis in Arizona. Really cool place. You've got to visit. But it's 13.3 ounces. It's 18 gauge string, Hyper G, strung at 42 pounds. Right, so yeah. It's a bit different, but
yeah.
That's my stick.
Yeah, to be honest, I like it. I love the way it feels. It reminds me of why I weighted up my old racket. This one here is the CX200 from Dunlop. So today I'm repping like Dunlop and Diadora, like my favorite ATP pro. Rob Galloway, who also lives here in Boulder County, top 50 in the world right now in doubles. And you know, I switched to this racket about 8 months ago, strung it up with Luxalon 4G, 17 gauge. The guys at Game Set Match kind of told me about that, and I love that combination. There's another string I love in that called Velocity with an I. But this one I was playing in the Longmont Open last week, and I wanted to have a consistent string, so I did two of the Luxalon 4Gs, and it played great.
Nice.
So yeah, it's a little bit lighter than this one. This thing's a beast. You know, I could feel that swing weight, but I think I'm gonna like it. So this is gonna be a fun racket swap.
Love, I've never done this. Yeah, I've never since 2014. I always try other rackets, and I just can't. I can't part with it.
Yeah.
I think there's a good way that I can try other rackets and force me to, because dude, I love the Head Speed Pro. Like, I think it's the greatest racket of all time.
Cool.
But you know, and Jokvic uses it. Let's go. Okay, so we're gonna have a warm up, solid warm up, as long as we need, just to get these going, get a feel for it. We're gonna play, and then we're gonna talk about the rackets, how we play with them, kind of little things that we thought about. I think that's just kind of the best thing.
Cool. All
right.
Well, let's do it. Let's do it.
Okay. I'm sorry. I messed that up. Oh my gosh. That was not the handshake we had when we were playing. Oh my gosh, good sir.
Yep. Oh.
Thank you. Yeah.
I could trick you by doing that. It worked last time we played.
Dude, what a battle. Yeah. Good times.
Yeah, so, I mean, that actually happened a lot in our third set last time. The whole, like, I remember you're like, I can't win on this. And so we, like, replayed a point. I think I ended up winning that set, the one that you did that in the second. But, yeah. Damn, dude.
Got to respect the battle.
Look at the
sweat,
dude.
You know, you got to respect the battle. That was great.
All right, yeah. I'm going to sit down, dude.
Yeah. I don't know if we're talking strategy or what, but...
Okay, so first we'll talk about the racket, so...
Yeah.
I definitely like mine more. It's funny, neither of us, I think, double faulted maybe once for each last match. And this time we both had, like, I think three or four in the first set. So, like, obviously rackets, that's probably the biggest thing that feels off, I think. I mean, like, your racket, like, you definitely had to... There were a couple times where I hit backhands and I was like, oh, I should have hit through it. Like, with higher tension, you have to swing through it. You have to step in.
Yeah.
You got to focus on your footwork. My racket, you can be lazy. You can kind of like, you know, just
point and shoot.
Do a nori.
It's got all that mass behind it.
You can swing like nori
right.
with low tension at 42. But I like 18 gauge. It still gives me the ton of spin. And it doesn't break. That racket has lasted me like a month.
Amazing.
So that's what's crazy. But it's just low tension, high gauge. So I get like good benefits. I like it. But yeah, dude, your Technifiber, it felt good.
Yeah, the serve. Dunlop.
Dunlop. Oh,
yeah, my Dunlop. Dunlop CX, yeah.
Almost a solid grip.
Yeah.
But dude, the control was crazy. Like, I felt really good control, but you definitely had to push through it a little bit more, muscle it in. But I liked it. It was similar to my racket, to my frame, which is good. That's it for yours, I think. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, like I said, I switched to that Dunlop. I like it, but I noticed the plow through on yours. You're a player that I have extreme trouble hitting through, right? You're really good at getting the ball that goes behind you. You're just like 98th percentile in that. And so I'm used to being able to like draw an air off of that ball and you just get to it and put it back. So I think with the plow through with yours because of the extra mass, I liked it. I mean, I struggled with the second serve. First point of the match, if you notice, I hit a ball that didn't even make it to the net. Because
yeah.
I was like, oh, okay, this is different. And I'm going to have to swing differently.
To the ground first,
so yeah, I, well, I just 100% know that I have to swing a little bit differently with that much mass behind it. But I like it. You know, I think each of our rackets work for each other, or ourselves, respectively, right? Yeah. You're a little bit of a bigger guy. You can handle the more mass. I'd probably, you know... my arms would get tired.
Yeah, dude. It was cool hitting against my racket. I've never hit against it because I've had people tell me it kicks a little bit. But yeah, like when you served with mine, like, dude, it just kept going. And I was like, I see.
Oh my gosh.
It's like, I see how, like, sometimes I'll ace people out wide and stuff and it hits the fence. And it's just the low tension stuff, so much spin. I definitely had struggle hitting that when you got it over. That was crazy. It was cool seeing that. I've always wanted to kind of experience that too. But yeah, I could use that Dunlop. That was not bad. But I like mine, honestly.
Oh, yeah, geez. I like yours too.
It's funny, in the second set, it was more breaks than holds.
That's right.
I think we broke like four or five times in a row. Boom, boom, boom. So
yeah.
I said in one of our videos, the one that got the most views on here, that like we both have like a counter puncher play style. Like, I'm really good at redirecting power, so is he. Like, and so, like, we'll try to wear our opponents down. I can tell you do that. Like, I love to do that. I love to make my opponents just play long matches. Be like, oh, my gosh, like, this guy's getting everything right. So, but, like, this guy's not even breathing.
Nah, that's not true.
He's, like, 40. How old are you?
43. Yeah.
He didn't even have water for the whole second set. I'm like, all right, he's going to tire out towards the end. I got him. I got this. But, dang, dude, crazy stamina, dude. Awesome. I was cheesing the whole match. Like, it's not just me being fake, dude. Like, I enjoyed that match. I love playing games like that where it's just like you gotta fight, right? Like, that's like, I had to get out the Muhammad Ali shirt, man. Like, it's my dad always compared tennis and boxing to be similar, because it's what it feels like, except you don't get hit in the face, which is great, right? No contact. But I mean, it's just your all versus their all, everything on the line, and it's such an awesome sport like that.
Yeah,
dude, I'm sorry.
Yeah, a lot of body shots back and forth. And and for us, I think, you know, we feel that where, you know, you get three or four or five balls in the same location, and then, you know, you kind of have to change direction. And it's good for us. I think it's good for our games to play each other, because then you learn, you know, hey, I mean, if you went back and analyzed, you know, the points that I lost, I wasn't finishing points against you, right? And if you don't do that against you, then you know you're in trouble. And we had so many fun points. It also leads to a lot of fun points.
Yeah, your volleys were on point. Yeah. My goodness, awesome volleys. Wow.
Yeah. Great playing, man. That was fantastic. Yeah.
Worth the 2-hour drive. Yeah. I was like, but I had to drive out and play. Let's see. Anything else? Yeah, dude.
What's your tension?
42 pounds.
42, so yeah. So that's a big difference. Mine, you know, 53, I'd probably hit with it, you know, 3 or 4 hours, just probably down to 51. But that's a big difference.
Yeah.
To play. Honestly, I felt pretty comfortable with yours. So I think I learned something today. I probably could go down in tension.
Yeah. I sell people on it a lot, because like I switched earlier because 42 is the Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, the number of life, right? Mm-hmm. So that's why I tried it, but it was more because I was having arm pain. But I wanted to use all poly, so I just kept lowering the tensions. I decided to just jump to 42 and be like, let's see what it's like. Ever since I heard Manorino does like 36 or 26.
Oh, I was he's way down.
I was like, why not try it, right? Yeah. And then I've just kind of fallen in love, because like I can do a lot of whips. I can wrist things in. If it's like really fast, so if I'm playing like a hard, super heavy hitter, I can just wrist it in. I can just absorb, mm-hmm. push back without having to wear anything, because it's a heavy racket with low tension. I just, I barely use any energy. So I love playing like tall guys, like, for that reason. Yeah. But dang, dude.
Just respect the battle, man. It's awesome to be out here, and that's one of the amazing things about tennis, is you can just live in the moment and live in that battle. And I think when, you know, you've got a great opponent, great sportsmanship, you know that you're both in it just for the fun of the battle. That's what makes it the most fun. I'm so glad I connected with you. And man, let's do it again. We'll get a little more daylight next time.
That's what I love about playing you, is like we both have like balls. Yeah. Like if it clips the line, you know, like, or if it's a little out, we end up just playing it, right? Yeah, like, because it's right? There's that point that he technically won. He's like, I can't win off of that. Redo it, right? So that, you know, like that's how my dad taught me to play. I love that mentality. Every match that I play like that with people, it's just, I go home, I feel great, I earn my sleep. Right, like it just feels good. So yeah, last pound to do.
Yeah. All right. You gotta give me the East Bowl.
Since I won it last time, right? So 2024 champs East Boulder, here we go.
Yeah, East Boulder Cup, you know. This is gonna stick with me a little while longer. Jarron, one day this could be you, right?
Taking it
back. You
know, taking it back when he's
right
50.
Here, because he gets a like that. One day. All right, we'll do it.
I wanted to show that towel. Where'd the towel go?
Oh, yeah, the towel right here.
That was right cute. Here. I like that towel.
These are who I just love more than life itself. Those little guys.
All right.
Yeah.
What is it? Live long and prosper. Here we go.
All right.